Hello everybody, Thorgal here, and welcome back to another episode of Bevo's Tech Pack here on the ftog community server. Now, you guys really liked the ore processing from last time, and I'm happy about that. It was a lot of fun setting it up, and I've actually spent a couple of hours, I think, tweaking this. I tore down actually all but this guy here and rebuilt it because I noticed, you know, I tried to make it less susceptible to getting stuffed. Okay, you guys also see we got a couple more smelters back here and so on. And the reason for this being is that you guys remember that we sorted the dust out not until the very end. So what happened is when we had a side product come out of the crusher here, right? Yeah, that's the crusher. It just kept going all the way to the grinder, and then at the grinder we decided, yes, take the crush, the clumps or whatever they're called. Actually right here, it's gonna tell me these guys right here, the chunks, and put them in, and otherwise the other stuff like the dusts and so on keep sending it forward. Well, that caused it to get stuffed up much easier because there's more stuff on the conveyor belts, right? So what I did now is after every machine, I pull it out and I put it into a buffer here, which right now is a wooden storage crate because, well, they look cool. And then I have right here the sorting. So this guy right here takes everything that is not chunks, okay? Because the chunks gonna go into the grinder. So it takes it and puts it on this secondary conveyor belt. And you guys see that goes straight back here and keeps going all the way directly to the smelter. So all the dust gets sorted out from the beginning and comes down to these electric furnaces, not smelters. All right, but let me show you guys what happens to the other stuff to you guys are all caught up. So the chunks come in here and then go into the grinder right there. And then this grinder pulls out right here, again, into a buffer. And if it's not a rubble blacklisted, which would be dust or something, it goes on this conveyor belt right here, which crosses over and merges in directly to the electric furnaces. The other stuff gets pulled out here, so that would be the come on, these guys right here that are rubble whitelisted go on to this one, which goes straight up to the second grinder, all right, and then goes into there. And then out of this grinder we're pulling out right here again in a buffer, and if it is pebbles it goes onto here, goes around, wait a second, this is blacklist. If it's not pebbles, it also goes on the dust belt, on the dust conveyor belt. And if it is pebbles, it goes right here onto this one, which goes in a loop. And I added a second sifter, because the sifter takes the longest, right? So this guy picks up everything, because the only thing that can come here is the pebbles, right? And it goes into here, the power is underneath, and the second one here kicks in once the first one is filled, and that one also picks up everything from these conveyor belts. And then in the back, very simple, we only get the dust, and then again goes into the electric furnaces. And I made a loop right here and right here, because it just works better that way. And it is also cooler with the up and downs here. It goes underneath, comes up over here, and back around the sifters. So that made a big difference. Now the problem is when I set up the digital miner, this will still get stuffed up eventually, okay? Because the digital miner is just so fast in only pulling ores. If you use a quarry, you know, let's say even with speed 2 or something, you still have to pick up all the cobble, the dirt, the gravel, everything, right? Limestone, marble, and all these things. But anyway, it comes back here, and then from here, it all goes into 8, right? Yeah, 8 ender chests. I'm getting so many dusts, guys. These are going nuts. When this is going at full swing with the digital miner, I'm getting about 8 ingots every 1.5 seconds from this setup. It is absolutely bananas, all right? But anyways, it's working nicely, and let me show you guys. I don't have any quarries, nothing running anymore. I got 43,000 iron and diamonds. I got 514. I got so much stuff. It's bananas. Okay. But today we're not going to spend any time here. We are going to start with our mob farms because I'd like to set up some mob farms so we don't need to cow farm, sheep farm and all that stuff anymore. And I did something on the live stream here. I think a week and a half ago or something, we built a room back here. Okay, it's a little hidden. You can barely tell. There's just a little secret button right there. And check this out, all right? This is supposed to mimic, like, you know, we were mining down here operation, and we broke into some weird chambers, right? Some magical area, kind of. And this is where we're going to have our mob farms. And we set most of this up on the live stream. So I'm going to have two cursed earth farms. I went really overkill here, guys. But nothing is going to run unneeded. So I'm going to make sure that these don't run if my mob essence is full and so on. So I don't need to, you know, constantly have mobs. And I have two. So I can have on demand lots of mob essence and fill it and done. Turn it off. Because, you know, the more mobs you have on the server, the worse it gets. And there's a door back here. There's actually a bunch of doors. And I'm going to open them all right now. So you guys know where they are. There's two right there. And then we also have right there. Okay. So behind these two cursed earth farms, there's the holes ready for the grinders, right? Three on this side, three on that side. And then, of course, we got to come down here. Three more here and three more on the other side. And then these two rooms here, or actually three rooms. There's one room right here and one right there. I have it ready for, let's say, about five auto spawners here, five auto spawners there. And this one back here is a single room. This is only for one, and that is for gas. Okay, let me show you guys the upstairs. The open computer, I don't know yet if I'm going to use it or not, but you guys see I was playing around here with these redstone interfaces from open computers and so on. But today I just want to make sure that we actually get the farms going, and then maybe next episode we're going to set it up so we have like a control board or something like that. For now, there's two levers down there in that hallway, and that just runs up here and turns these redstone lamps on or off. And just as an FYI, I used these guys right here, the black lamps from Project Red Illumination, and they did not, they're very buggy, let's just say it like this. I had the same arrangement. I didn't see any X's while other people did see X's with NEI, you know, this stuff right here. There is a magnet torch underneath us, so nothing can spawn here. But on Cursed Earth didn't care, right? And then we even noticed this when we had zombies run directly underneath the lamps. When they're on, they burned. So it a little weird. So I just took regular redstone lamps. They work. And now over here, let me show you guys. We have three times vanishing blocks. It's very dark here. Apologize for that. But this is going to be, this is a little bigger room. You guys see that? This is not a 10 by 10 like these two rooms. This is a 11 by 11. Yes. Reason being is that here, I'm going to have the auto spawner directly underneath. And by the way, here, you guys see this? These are all facade blocks from Ender.io, so I can run the wires directly in it and you won't be able to see them. I got all that prepared. And this one is big enough that when the auto spawners right here, for gas to spawn, you need a 5 by 4 by 5. So 5 by 5 and 4 tall at minimum for a gas to spawn. And that's why this one is 11, 11. You guys see this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's 5 to here. In all directions, there is 5 room. And when the auto spawner is here, there's going to be 4 underneath and 4 above. So I can make full use of this room. But that got me thinking, and I'm not sure if this is going to work yet. The grinders I'm going to put here, because the grinder is actually a 5 by 5 by 5. So it will actually go to here. It goes 2 up, 2 down, 2 to the left, 2 to the right, and 5 in front of it. So because gas are so big, when I put them in the middle, they should be able to reach every single gas that spawns in here. At least that's what I'm hoping for. It's got to be tested, but it'd be cool if it works. All right, and then of course we got these two. Let me open them. And now you guys see something in my hands that I've been waiting to show you because that's quite new. And this is what we're going to use to come down here. I got sick and tired of having to jump down the mine shaft right here, right? Every time and fly back up. That I decided I'm going to make something really cool. And if you're a Futurama fan, you're going to love this. And these things are called viaducts. Okay? And what we're going to do is we're going to simply place them. Whoop. all the way going up. You guys see those are pretty big. They're not hard to make at all. You need a fluid transposer and so on. You need me to make some fancy thingamajiggy here. Let me see what it's called. Recipe. This stuff right here. Cephirian erothium, which you get from erothium dust, which is made with saltpeter, blitz powder. And the blitz powder I made by pouring redstone over sand. That's how I got this, okay? It was easy to make. You just got to figure it out, the recipe. So, but anyway, we got these tubes, right? And they don't do anything by themselves. You wrench this right here, okay? Now you see we have an opening. And then again, click it with an empty hand. And I'm going to name this top. And then we have to go down one time manually. Bang. And down here, we're going to do the same thing. We wrench this right here. And we're going to call this config bottom. You can have multiple stops. I have not found any limitations on how far you can go and so on. But now when I click on this, you guys see it shows me I am on the bottom and I can go to top. I click on this and check it out. Is this cool or what? I love it. You can actually see people going up and down. Let's see if I can see that with F5. It's probably going to be hard to see. But you see this? I'm facing downwards, so like I'm flying. I love it. Oh, oh, there we go. So that's going to be my way to get up and down from here. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to use that a lot. So I'd say we're just going to get started now. I got this huge project bag. I did lots of crafting. Well, I had the ME do a lot of crafting for me. And the first thing we're going to set up is the machines itself. All right. So let me go ahead around and place these 22 grinders in all these. How did that just open? That must have been a delayed thing. So I'm going to place these 22 grinders everywhere. I got a little sidetracked here because I noticed when I was editing the video that it was quite dark. And I was looking through the different night vision options. Oh. Just night. One of them, of course, would be the dark helm. One would be the night vision goggles and so on. But I don't want to... It's kind of funny, actually, because I said I don't want to spend that much time. I just want quick night vision. I should have just made potions, right? But then I found this guy right here, the night vision module. And I haven't played around a lot with those yet. So I decided I want to make one of them. And if you check the recipe, we need a syringe with a mob cave spider. So I spent about half an hour in a mineshaft underneath our base. Which is... This is a roguelike dungeon here, by the way, that I somewhat cleared. Let me see here. We're not too far from home. Right here. That's where the ship is. And there's a mineshaft underneath this area here that I knew about, but I could not find a night vision spawner, yeah. I couldn't find a cave spawner there. So I came over here and I cleared. There's a few baddies out here still, even though everything is lit up. You know how they just keep spawning if you don't light it up perfectly. So, but anyway, I made this room here and I just want to go ahead and spawn, you know, maybe one or two of these if possible. And then I don't know if I'm going to have to left click or right click. I want to make it. I already hear spider in the wall. Wait a second. Somewhere here? Where you at? Ooh, I got string. Thought I got string. Where is this dude at? What's going on with the magnet? Why is this not picking it up? Back here? Yes! Ooh, a named one. Right click doesn't work. Left click. Aha, I gotta beat it with that thing. Oh, man. Don't die. Don't die. It's full. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Oh, boy. Half a heart. All right, guys. Well, I got this thing at 100%. I'm going to wait until I heal back up and make my way back home. And then we'll go ahead and craft this night vision module and the environmental controller. I think that's what it's called. This thing right there. I got all this prepared already, so I'll see you in a second. Alright, I made it home safe and sound. This is the environmental controller. We need this. And then, let's see if I can find it without searching. Right here in the night vision module, I should have the rest of the stuff. Perfect. I think that is all I need. I have not used it very often yet, this environmental controller. Should I set this up? I think on the bottom. I don't think it's gonna be here permanently. I just want to have it for this episode and possibly the next one. So it's just easier to see in the episode. So let's see. Middle is about here. So why don't I put it down right here for now? It's probably in a sphere, so we'll put it right there or something. Okay, let me get one of these tesseracts. We have plenty of them. Oh, I totally forgot. Well, actually, this one we can set up the regular channel. There's not going to be anything on it. So we're going to go to private. Uncheck this, that, and receive only. Turn this off. Wind power done. And now we can put this controller right there. And I think all we do is put this in here. All right, radius 50. That's very large. Height 30, 70. I don't know what all that means. Player in the list above will not get the effects. Add a player to the list. Stuff, redstone mode ignored. Okay. Oh, I already have it. How much does this draw? Does it tell me somewhere? Uses 0.001. So very little. Okay, I don't think there is a way for me to see how much this draws, but it can't. Oh, actually, here. 322 RF a tick. Wow. Okay. But that's fine. It doesn't matter. It's wind power. It's free for now. I don't have a quarry go, nothing. And it is really nice and bright. I like that a lot. And I think for the time being, particles, let's turn them to minimal. I don't want to see the purple. Perfect. All right. So I got the... Whoa. What? Did... I don't have any more grinders. Did I miscount? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24. I really forgot to. I can't believe it. Here is the 24th. Now we got them all. Can't believe I miscounted that. And now I figured we're going to set up the auto spawners first. And once we got all the blocks set up, then we'll go ahead and figure out how we want to wire everything and what we're going to use. So the first one we're going to use is right there. That's the one for the guests. It actually has 4 underneath and 5 above. So that should work really nicely. And nothing can spawn on the top. And I'm going to go over here. Now these right here are going to always have more room in on this side right there. But that is fine by me. Let's start on the bottom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I only have one air gap above it. I wonder if that is going to be enough. Now let's do the other one the same. I hope that one gap is not going to hurt it. Above it. 2, 4, 5. Just like that. Okay. And now, of course, comes the fun part of wiring this up. While I'm here, I'm just going to start here. So every one of them is going to get fluid. Oh. These only do 100 millibuckets a tick. I wonder if I should use... Can I upgrade these? The ender fluid ducts. And they can do 200 millibuckets a tick. Because, you know, if I have multiples of these going at the same time, that might become a bottleneck. I think I am going to upgrade those guys. Why not? We have tons of materials. Let's see real quick if I maybe have enough. So we can craft that real quick. I'm not even gonna bother with a autocrafting recipe. At least not right now. And let's see here. Conduit. It's this one right here, right? The ender fluid conduit. So it's gonna take... Alright, we have some of it, but that's fuse quartz. Do I have hardened glass? Yes. This is a lot easier for me to make than the fused glass. And let's see how many we can get. 60, cool. And let's upgrade these also if we can. Wrong one. Right there. Alright, that's enough. That should be plenty. I'm so happy that we were able to just do this real quick. And go back down. Pull this onto here. And every one of them, of course, is gonna get power, a redstone, and also the fluid. And I think that is all we're gonna need. And I'm gonna show you guys one real quick. And then I'll wire up the other two off camera. Let's start from right there. Because I'm gonna use this so every one of them is different. Now, guys, the thing is that... Oh. That's gonna be tricky. I'm gonna have to... I don't think I will actually make it. Whoa. What? What was that? Weird. I think it was because it got a redstone update or something. That's why it closed again. Now my problem is how I'm gonna get out. I guess I gotta break it. So we got redstone fluid. What I was thinking of is, you know, if I add item conduits, then I could pump them in and out also. Hello? Do you mind staying open? Thank you very much. Let's close this one. But, like I said, I wanted to show you guys. I'm gonna set every one of them. Gonna have to... I can't. Like that. So, this is the fluid. Fluid, we're only gonna insert. Redstone signal. And that is one thing now. I'm gonna have to figure out how I wanna do it. We're only gonna have an in-out. And I don't want to use red by default. So I'm going to go from the bottom up. So the bottom on this one is going to be green. And power is going to be insert. On this one, we're going to do the same spiel. Fluid is going to be only insert. The redstone signal is going to be brown, the second one. And then power is going to be insert. And the same one for this, insert. Blue and power insert. I know that you don't need to do the power, but I always like to wrench my conduits the proper way. So this is purple. Right, that was red. 1, 2, 3, 4. We are on the fourth one. Okay. And then, oops, last but not. Okay. Okay, I'll be right back. After the server restart, I decided to finish the conduits here real quick. So they're all pulled up all the way, and I also went to the nether and picked up our first three victims. A ghast, a blaze, and a wither skeleton. And by the way, these safari nets are much more expensive than they usually are because it takes a porter spawner, which takes a nether star. But I have a bunch of nether star. I have 9 more, I think. Oh man, the TPS is really bad right now. Well, here we are. There's 9 nether stars. Oh, it's because I can't type the T for some reason. One of you guys told me apparently it's a key binding in extra utilities or something, but I forgot to check that. And we cannot put the levers on here directly on the insulated redstone cable, so we're gonna have to put facades here, okay? So I painted them with steel. I might repaint them later. And don't forget that this is right now temporary until we set up our control station that might even be upstairs. I don't know yet exactly. And we're going to use the levers right there. So that's for these 5 spawners, for these 5, and for this one. And eventually, I think I would like to add a way of exchanging every one of these different spawners, the safari nets in them, via an automated system. That's something down the line that we are not going to get done today for sure. So the first thing we're going to set up is this one right here. So this is red. I'm going to set this to green. I'm not going to use red at all. Okay. None of these are triggered by red. This is only one, the gas spawner. And the easiest way to test if this actually works right now. What's going on? Why can I not fly? What is happening? Okay. Guys, am I missing something? What is happening? I have an angel ring. We are on 1-7. What is going on? What? I guess I'm gonna have to restart real quick. That was super odd. I have no idea what happened. I only noticed it because when I jumped down here, I heard the bone breaking sound. But now after logging out and back in, it works. Weird. Anyway, the easiest way to check if this works is we gotta give it power and stuff first. Before then, we won't be able to know if it works. And every one of these three is gonna get a tesseract. And for this, we're gonna set up a whole new network. So this one right here is fluid. This is going to be extract only, always active. The redstone signal we don't need on this one. It's gonna be disabled. And the power is going to be extract only. And now my neighbor's dog is barking. It's one of these days, guys. Sometimes it happens when you're trying to record, everything in the world goes wrong. I'm not kidding. First, my cat puked earlier when I started recording. Then my dog did not stop bothering me. She wanted to go out like 9 times in an hour. And now the neighbor's dog starts barking. But anyway, owners only. And we're going to start using number 2. Okay? And this one we're going to call Mob Farms. Everything is going to run on this new channel that I'm making here. That means we're going to need to set up new power input. And then, of course, this one also is item. It's not going to do anything. This one does not handle any items, this tesseract. Fluid receive and energy receive. Okay? So that works. So now when we go down here, this should... Oh, of course, I need to set up the power that is coming out from upstairs. My dog, my neighbor's dog is distracting me so much right now. Sorry, guys. I hope it's not too loud. Let's go up and we'll set this one up real quick and then we'll test if the lever works, but it should. I'm pretty confident that it does. And the way we're doing it is right here. I decided to put it into the ground. Right there, a new tesseract. Because it's outputting from this basic energy cube, right? And we're gonna set this to private. Redstone always active. No items, no fluids, and energy we're going to send on Mob Farms. Check. All right, good. So that's where it comes. I could set this up directly up at the wind farm wherever I want it, but I like to have it there in our reactor room. Fake reactor room. It's just mimicking from the spaceship. And now when we go back, I love these tubes. But it definitely would be a lot more helpful if I'd actually set up a mech teleporter here for the time being. So, now hopefully my flight works. Yep. See, right there. Energy's gone and you see it's idling. It's actually trying to do something. And now if I come up here, turn this lever on. Alright, that is weird. Anyway, here it stopped. Because this one is also on... green right there. So I'm disabling this. All right, guys, I'm gonna set up the other 5 here the same way. I'm gonna go left to right. So this one here, I'm gonna wrench 1 time. This one here, 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, four. And one, two, three, four, five. This should be, yeah, the mint color. There we go. So now these five. And of course, I'm going to turn them all on. So if I put something in, it doesn't just spawn. And then back here, we're going to do the same spiel. We're going to set up the Tesseract the same way I just did this one. I'm going to set this one up and that one. And then we'll continue with the Cursed Earth. I just finished a lot of off-camera work, guys, because it was a lot of running of conduits and configuring those. And it took me over an hour and a half to do this. So obviously way too much to show on camera, but it's always the same thing. So I figured I'm going to explain it to you rather than show you, you know, only half of it or a fraction of actually setting it up. Now, this is split up in two parts. We have two configurations that repeat themselves over and over. One that repeats four times in these cells, on this wall, on that wall, and that wall. And the second configuration is the same one for six other walls. These two back here, these two, and these two. Let me show you guys the ones up here for the Cursed Earth first. And it looks like this. I have a lot of conduits left over now because first I ran them all up and I wanted to bring them together. And then I said that's way too many conduits because these conduit bundles actually, while they're not bad for a server because you have three or four different things happening in one block, they do start to show up on the tick meter. Okay, so I tried to minimize it, you know? So, but anyways, so what we're doing here is out of these grinders on the Cursed Earth Farms, we are extracting the fluid and we're inputting power. So down here, you guys see extract on the fluid and come on, switch, insert to power. Let me get rid of that and actually close any eye for now. So that is the same on every one of the 6, 12 grinders, right? And the item conduit doesn't start until here. So the item conduits are not connected to the bottom of the three grinders. They are right here and underneath here. See, this is the item extract always active on all 12 of these grinders chests. And then these four sets of always three grinders are controlled by one tesseract. That is that change I made in the end. So, well, there's lots of tesseracts, but it's a lot better. And these tesseracts you guys see, they are set to item send, fluid send, and energy receive. Okay, and then you guys see here, fluid send, item send, energy receive. The reason why I'm using chests is, and I've explained this a couple times before, these MFR machines. Let's say you kill a skeleton, and that gets you a bow and an arrow. So that's two items. But the grinder can only send one item at a time into the conduit. It will send the bow, but then have a split second, you know, like one tick, I guess, delay, which stops the work process and it resets it. And then the idle will start ticking down again. And when the idle is down, then it will continue killing mobs. So you can actually, if you don't need the chests, but the chests make sure that you will have a continuous killing spree, pretty much. You will never stop get interrupted. Because you guys see that little hole back here on the grinder, it will automatically output in adjacent inventory, so this chest, so it can't just spit them out. And the chests never fill up, okay, until your receiving end is full, of course. And then the nice thing is if you have a chest, the MFR grinder, same as the harvester, the fruit picker, the rancher, and so on, they will automatically stop, so you can never have item spillage either, okay? So I always recommend you having a chest on all MFR machines. That's just a really good habit. So anyway, we're getting the fluid and the items from the grinders, and we're sending that into our Tesseract system. And we do the same on all four sides, okay? And then the other ones here, that is the... Yeah, there's the other grinders. Ooh, I forgot the chests. Are you kidding me? That must be the only ones I forgot. I didn't forget these over here, right? No. All right, let me get some chests real quick. Gotta craft three more. Maybe that's why I didn't do it, because I forgot them. But we'll just put those down real quick, because I really want to kick this in here in a minute. So let's put this here. And guys, I have double and triple checked everything. And every time I do it, I find something else that I forgot to change. So extract, insert, extract, insert, and extract, insert. Yeah, and I know that we have this conduit probe, that's why you guys see it here, but I've been having problems today. You can copy the settings and then paste them to the other conduits, but I've had some problems today with the conduit probe. I'm not sure if it was the angle or what it was, so I just rather do it all by hand. So extract always, extract always. In case you're wondering how I do that, by the way, without touching, you know, usually you need to, let me go down to here. You know, you need to right-click this gray plate, and then I can get here and click the buttons, right? But if you're up here, of course, you cannot get to that gray plate, right? But if you have a Yeda wrench from Ender.io, and you shift-left-click a conduit, it shows it to you, okay? It opens that same interface. So that's how I did it. All right, again, these four walls are the same. Now let's continue to these... They are somewhat six different walls, but these long ones are connected here. I did the same thing here, okay? All the chests that you see here are extract, and they're all sitting at the back of the grinder. And underneath, instead of, well, I'm doing the same thing. Actually, the grinders are all exactly the same setup, all right? The difference I have here is that it does not go, it does not send the fluid into the tesseract here. You guys... Ooh. Apparently, I forgot to disconnect this one also. Happening. I'm telling you, I did this a million times, so let's start. Items, insert, fluid, I am disabling. And power, I'm extracting. Because the fluid, I actually void on a trash can, okay? I don't care about the mob essence that we get from these auto spawners. I should say from the grinders that are killing the mobs from the auto spawners. Because that is what we have our cursed earth for, okay? And the problem is that if I spawn mobs, right, and I'm full of mob essence, then these, again, would get slowed down. Because if the internal buffers, just like on the harvester, these here fill, the grinder will slow down. So make sure you void that. That's why I have trash can here across, and then also one right there and on the other side. So let me just double check here real quick. This is not connected. Receive and send. Receive and send. Receive and send. So I only forgot the fluid on that one over there across. And these tesseracts here are all set to item send. Okay. Fluid. We don't want anything. And energy. Now I'm going to make sure I have that the same. I guess I messed that up on every one of them. We're not doing anything with fluids on these four tesseracts because we're voiding the fluid. Yeah, here I did it right. And here I also... Alright, so again, item sent, energy receive. Alright, I'm telling you, that was a lot of setting up. And I probably forgot a couple more things that I need to fix. And then up here, these are all, we did them earlier, receive, fluid, and energy. Because the fluid, and I'll show you guys where it comes from in a second, will actually come also from the tesseracts, okay? So what I'm about to show you guys is actually just a buffer. We'll see how that works out. Maybe I have to make another network with tesseracts, but we'll see. And then the last one is this one right here, this tesseract, and all I'm doing here is receiving the items. So from all 24 grinders, the items come to this tesseract. And I put a chest here because I did not know if it can spit out into the conduit fast enough. So we're using this as a buffer. And here, extracting, always active. And I have three diamond chests. Okay, that's all I have here. This is just for today. We're going to set something else up, of course, with an auto sorting system and so on. And then the last thing is this buffer I was talking about. And I put this over here above the Cursed Earth Farms, okay? And how that's going to work is, here is a tesseract that is set to receive fluids. And here is the tesseract that's set to send fluids, okay? So if the other tesseracts are not sending it fast enough, this one here is actually the one that is supposed to supply the three tesseracts over here for the auto spawners, right? This tesseract will automatically put the fluid it receives from the grinders, from the Cursed Earth Farm, into this drum. And then you have to pump it out of the drum, you guys see here, always active, into this tesseract. And here I have a comparator with a lever next to it, and you guys see when you look on the bottom right in Vanilla, redstone power 15. That's the highest amount of redstone you can get in vanilla Minecraft. And this comparator compares to this signal, which is 15. And it also reads the drum. The drum, the fuller it gets, the stronger of a redstone signal this guy will get. When the drum is full, it will be 15. And a comparator will not give out a redstone in the front until the signal from the back, where these two are, is equal or higher than the signal on the side. Okay, make sure you don't have it in subtract mode. Just normal mode. So once this is full, it will pulse a redstone signal, which then will turn this. I had to put a repeater here because you guys see there's a redstone signal here because it comes from this rednet cable, okay? But once I flip these two levers down there, my manual override, my shutoff, like I don't want anything to spawn, I don't care what's going on, then this will be off, right? And when this gets full, then it will power it. I hope this makes all sense, and the only way to find out if this actually works is to try it out. But before we do that, I wanted to get down there first. Now, what did I write here? I put some signs here. This is the wither skeleton. Let's put this one. The far left was the furthest on the bottom. So that's the wither skeleton. We'll put that in here. And this one, we got to make sure exact copy. Yes. Okay, because otherwise, I think you can get regular skeletons. Let's close the hatch. We're not going to turn it on just yet. This one is the blaze. Again, I'm going to use the bottom one. This one here, you can leave exact copy no, because, well, there's only one blaze. There is no different blaze. So you save some mob essence. And the last one here is the ghast. And this one, you guessed it, exact copy no, because, well, there's only one type of ghast. So that's, this one is closed. This one is closed. They're all closed. So now it's time to go downstairs and activate our cursed earth farms first and see if they work. And while I'm at it, I'm going to close all the hatches here. And this and that. And turn off the lights. What? Houston? There must be some kind of a loopback. Let's check. What is happening here? Because they're touching here? Well, this is off. So where is it getting? It can't be this one here. This is quite silly, I have to say that. This did not work, but after about 20 minutes of tinkering around with this, I ripped out all the rednet cables and I just read vanilla redstone. And I also set it up, so I did split this up. I wrenched all kinds of different ways. I broke all the redstone lamps and replaced them again. I just don't know. I have no idea what is happening, why this is causing such problems. And now the last thing I just need to do is, let's just like this, and then one more here. So that should always get enough power here. If the signal comes over there, it will be strong enough. Okay, so now these lights should turn off when I flip these levers over. If not, then I am giving up. Lights are off. Lights are off. Yay, finally. Okay, so now this is going to have time. It's been running for a little while here with the lights on and off, so it hasn't spread yet. But now that it's in full darkness, the cursed earth should spread all the way. And don't forget, it only looks so bright because we got this night vision thing. It's actually pitch black dark in here. F7, you guys see everything is red. Whoa, that's a big Enderman over here. Whoa, you scared me a bit. So, let's go upstairs and check out how we're doing over there. And let me have a little bit of Sunday roast. Okay, so how we doing on mob essence? Now all these auto spawners, of course, are gonna fill. Oh, but holy shnikes, 120 buckets already. Wow. And all the auto spawners are full here, guys. Don't forget that. Every one of these is also full with 4 buckets already. Holy shnikes, that is awesome. It is so fast. Well, then I really want to see if this is gonna turn off by itself. So I think I'm gonna cut one more time, guys. I'm sorry. And I'm gonna wait until this drum is full, because I wanna see if it turns off. Alright, we're getting really close to the 256 buckets. And I'm really hoping this is gonna work. Bam, you see that? Triggered. All the lights are on. And now the mob farms are off. So whenever I'm full of mob essence, it disables the cursed earth farm. So that is awesome. And now, last but not least, of course, we still need to turn on these guys right here. Give them a few seconds to warm up. And in the meantime, we can check what kind of... Oh my lord, is that a lot of loot. Oh my goodness. That is a lot of gobbledygook. Wow. Alright, 5 ender pearls, which isn't bad. I was kind of hoping for... There's a guest here already. A blaze rod. This must have been from the... Well, actually, now that we're using up mob essence, check it out. These are on again. Because now we're, of course, using mob essence. And it looks like we are using it faster than we're making it. With only 3 spawners. Oh, okay. It's catching up now. Okay. Let's go downstairs and check it out what our guests look like. I really want to see how they're spawning. There we are. There's a blaze. And the grinders are going to take a second to kick in, you know, because they always have the cooldown period. There it goes. First. And then also. That's perfect that we get guests spawning. How are we doing on the wither skeletons over here? There's one. And I do not know. I just captured them just to show you guys something today. But I actually do not know if we can even get skulls that way. A lot of times in packs, the grinder skulls is disabled. Oh, android arm. Nice. So I'm going to let this run for a bit. So next episode, I can tell you guys if we got wither skeleton skulls. But I doubt it. I highly doubt it. I think we're going to have to set something else up. Glitch wanted to set up. He built a really cool nether castle. I'm going to show you guys. Maybe next episode. And he wanted to set up with the skeleton farm over there anyway. We're going to figure out something fun. 18 gas tiers already. And then, of course, he also built a wither boss farm already. Or killer, I should say. Which... we're gonna improve, I think, next time also. But anyway, huge farm, lots of work. This took me forever to set up today. I don't have an explanation why this RetNet cable messed up here this way it did. That was just weird. But anyways, guys, that is all I got for today. Mob essence kicked up. That is awesome. And I hope you enjoyed the episode, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care, stay safe, and bye-bye.